Hi everyone, I'm Nicole Alabi and welcome back to my channel. My channel is all about fashion, specifically wardrobe building and lifestyle because I've lived a lot of life. So if you're interested in that kind of content, please make sure that you like and subscribe and make sure you turn on the notification bell so you can get notifications for when I post new videos. This video is going to be all about packing for a wedding weekend as a wedding guest. So it's not exactly a pack with me, because I've already done it and I'm filming this after the fact. Sorry, I know. Don't worry, I have a trip to Palm Springs coming up in the next 2 weeks and I'm gonna make sure to film a video before I go. But anyway, this video is all about my packing methodology. I'm a bit of a weekend warrior. I am a weekend person. I go out of town for weekends all the time. Maybe it's because I work so much, I really look forward to the weekends, but anyway. I go out of town for weekends all the time, and I am an expert at packing for the weekend, an expert. And I truly believe there's a methodology to it. This video is not a technique video like, this is how I roll my sweaters, and this is, I think there's plenty of videos doing that. Right now, I want to help you guys understand why I pack, what I pack, and my thought process. Got it? Great. So let's get started. So first thing I like to do is organize my thoughts. I open up the Notes app in the iPhone. Don't know what it's called for non-iPhone users, but it should be Notes. I open up the Notes app and I like to create a heading for what I'm going for. So this one was LA wedding weekend. Next, I might like to make a list of all the days that I'm going. So for this one, I was flying in on Friday and flying out on Monday, Labor Day. So Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. Next, I like to use those cute little like to-do list bubbles to make check-offs for how I'm spending my time. So that's the first thought in my methodology. How are you going to be spending your time? That's how you decide to pack. I know, it's genius. So for example, because this is a wedding weekend, I always start with official wedding events. On this weekend in particular, the wedding was on Sunday, so that was like the first thing I put in. And then the bridal shower was on Friday, so that's what I put in. We also had an unofficial welcome party on Saturday, which was a pool party, so I put that in as well. First off, I want to say thank God for you brides and bridal parties who are making wedding weekends so much more full. I feel like in the past, you know, wedding events were spread out through the year, but I'm noticing, and maybe it could be a COVID thing or like people are becoming more economic thing, not sure, but I'm noticing that more brides and bridal parties are putting more wedding events in the actual weekend. Like I've seen some weddings where like the bachelor parties at the beginning of the weekend. So for this one in particular, the bridal shower was at the start of the weekend. So you put in all of your official things. Next, you put in travel. You need to plan your travel outfits. You must. We'll get more into that, but put in travel. I also make a little note for sleep, and we'll get into that because you are gonna spend your time sleeping at some point. And then for anything where I don't know what we're doing, or I'm trying to be, you know, down for whatever, I put day or night and a question mark because I don't know what we're doing. But I have a methodology to pack for when you don't know exactly what you're gonna be doing. So tip number one, organize your thoughts in a Notes app. I'm one of those people that likes to start packing pretty much as soon as I know I'm going somewhere, just kind of getting my thoughts together. So this little list is super, 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 super helpful. Travel. Plan your travel looks. I get it. We all want to be very comfortable when we're traveling, but I think you've got to find this marriage between comfort and chic. Like it just cannot be all comfort. Like it can't be all comfort at all. Why? There are a lot of reasons why. And I'm gonna tell you a couple of them. So reason number one why it can't just all be about comfort. One, I have never had a time ever where the plane lands and the hotel check-in sync up. Even if you plan it that way and you check into the, you get to the hotel and they're like, oh, thank you for checking in and thank you for staying with us, blah, blah, blah. Your room's not ready yet. You're like, check-in is 3 o'clock and it's 3:01. How's my room not ready? So it's very rare that the two sync up. And so you might find yourself having to, you know, do some work from the hotel lobby or get a bite in the hotel restaurant or somewhere nearby. You don't want to do that in your pajamas. You just don't. Like, you just don't. It's not a nice look. You know, we can talk about bonnets later. I'm not about
the airport and the Walmart, and you got a bonnet on and you got slippers on and you looking like, what the
fuck? To get into all of that. But I feel like you're not doing a service to yourself when you're in like a nice restaurant or the hotel lobby looking like you're ready for bed. So I think it's nice to plan your travel outfits because you're kind of prepared for anything in case you're not able to go straight to your hotel, or if you haven't planned to go straight to your hotel. For example, I've had trips where I have to go from the flight to a meeting. I'm not trying to maneuver getting dressed in an airplane bathroom or airport bathroom. I'm sorry, I'm not doing that. Balancing on one foot, trying to make sure your bare foot doesn't touch your, like, I'm not doing that. So I like to make sure I'm planning a look where if I have to go somewhere from this airport, I don't feel uncomfortable and I don't look crazy. Another reason, y'all never know who you gonna meet in the airport. I'm telling you, we could do another video on the best places to meet men, but I'll tell you, my two favorite places to meet men, airport, particularly a sky lounge, or in a hotel restaurant or a lobby bar. You always meet men in those places. So you don't want to be there in your leggings and your bonnet and your neck pillow dangling off your backpack. Like, plan your travel looks. So those are typically the first things I do on my little list. So for going to LA, I wore the Frankie Shops Louis set in the light blue. I love this little set. I was very late to the cohort game because I just felt like it didn't always look expensive. But I feel like a lot more high-end brands or luxury brands are providing cohort options. And I just really love this Frankie Shop set. It's so comfortable. It's a cotton. And so if it wrinkles, it's still nice. So I really like this for flying. I wore it with like a little bralette from Aritzia. I believe it was TNA. I'm going to link every single thing in the description box. I'm one of those people, I get very hot when I'm anxious. And so when I'm typically traveling, I have to be in layers. I have to. Traveling, I'm not anxious about traveling because of like safety or I feel weird. Some about being close to strength, people being too in my space gets me very anxious.
Back up. Mind your business, that's all. Mind your business.
So I like to travel in layers. I also traveled in my Jordan 1s. Again, everything is not about meeting men. But let me tell you, actually, I want to do a video on the kind of sneakers I think all girls should have. But Jordan 1s are the best sneaker, I think, for women. They're high top, so if you have big feet like me, you don't look crazy, this crazy long boat foot. But they come in such great colors. And then also, because they're a retro pair, people notice them. Like, sneakerheads notice them. Men are always like, I never have worn those Jordan 1s without someone being like, okay. So they're comfortable to travel in, and they were super cute with the little set. And then I wore this little Balenciaga bag. I do not carry big old totes in the airport. I just don't. For some reason, I've noticed that when you have a big bag, you want to fill it. You're like, do I need a book? Do I need a magazine? Do I need a snack? On a plane, I want to eat, drink, and sleep. So I carried my little Balenciaga bag. It's enough to fit a mask, sanitizer, phone, wallet, keys, sunglasses, just kind of all the things I'll need when I land. And also, it's like a chicer look. Like, when you're already rolling a roller bag, having a big old tote in a backpack is just the worst with traveling. I hate when I'm seated next to someone who has a rolling bag and a backpack, because I know you're about to put your roller bag up top and you're going to put your backpack under your feet. If this is a short flight, I trust that you could keep your feet on top of your bag. But a long flight to LA, I know you're not. I know you're not. I know you're about to be leaning on the armrest on me. You're going to be straddling your bag. Like, keep it chic and easy to maneuver in the airport. So that's what I traveled in. So that was the look I planned for going. Also packed my coming look. Now, could you recycle the look? Sure, maybe. But after it's been on a plane in these worlds of COVID, I just packed that up and put that in my laundry packing cube. I usually have two packing cubes, one for clean clothes and one for dirty clothes. So I just put that one right in the dirty clothes one after. But the look I planned for coming, which is actually my typical favorite travel look, I like to travel in a knit midi dress. I know some people are like, girl, yes, I do. I like it because it's stretchy and it's comfortable, but it's also very chic. So I'm typically traveling in a knit midi dress and a piece of outerwear. The way I select the piece of outerwear is, this is typically the one piece of outerwear I'm going to be able to wear the whole weekend. So I want to make sure it's something that kind of goes with everything. So for this trip, on the way back, what I decided to pack was a rib knit high neck midi dress from Zara. This dress, I think, was like $18, and I should have got it in more colors, except I didn't like the other colors. But I have the black one and I love it. In hindsight, I wish I bought two of them. And then this Reformation double-breasted black blazer. I love this blazer. I've had this blazer since 6 or 7 years. I got it on sale during their like summer sale 7 years ago, and I've had this blazer repaired. I'll never get rid of it. I just love it. I love it because it drapes really nicely on a midi dress, but also looks really good with jeans. So this is something I would pack. If it was a little cooler outside, I would probably pack a black motorcycle jacket, a leather jacket. So that was my going look and my coming look. So travel, check, check. Sleep, plan pajamas. Pack a pair of pajamas. I was never a pajama person. I'm typically the kind of person who I sleep in my drawers every night. But pack a pair of pajamas. It's just a nice little transitional outfit to have in the hotel. Between meals or between events, or if you're sharing a room with a friend, like in this case, because it was a wedding for our sorority sister, I was sharing it with another sorority sister. So she don't want to see me in my drawers all night, you know, like pack a nice pair of pajamas, because one of the ways you're spending your time is sleeping. Remember, our list is based on how we are spending our time. So these pajamas are Lauren, Ralph Lauren, and I got them from Macy's, honestly. You can get a nice pair of satin pajamas or even linen pajamas on Amazon, H&M Home. I love the cooling PJs from Sleepover or from Skims. That kind of, what is that material called? It's like a modal. Those are really cooling for people who are hot sleepers like your girl. So always pack a pair of pajamas. You can wear them when room service comes. You don't look crazy. You can wear them if someone else is staying in the hotel and they pop by your room, because that's what happened. Like a lot of us were staying in the same hotel. You don't look crazy. So yes, pack a pair of pajamas. Next, I'm thinking about the official wedding event, because that's what we're going for. So the first look I made sure was completely together. It was what I was wearing to the wedding ceremony. So the wedding was for my friend and line sister, dear friend, Ashley Blaine Featherson, and it was a formal wedding, and all guests had to wear all black. So my first thought was I wanted to wear something really, really classic, sexy, beautiful, but that I could move around in. I had a very like 90s supermodel vibe going on in my head, and I was saving that vibe on Instagram and on my Pinterest. And I finally decided to go with this Hervé Léger icon gown. Some people might think Hervé Léger is played out. You can think that if you want, but I believe it was last year, Hervé Léger relaunched the icon dresses, the dresses that kind of made them famous over the last 30 years or however long it's been. And I've wanted that icon column gown for years, like years. And it went on sale, child, for like 70% off. So it went from like $12.95 to like three something. Bought it, bagged it. And then I packed my Amina Mawadi Gilda sandals, which you all saw in my shoe try on video. If you haven't seen it, I'll link it. Those ones, you know, I went through an extensive process trying to find the most comfortable shoes. Quick little review on these. So remember when we were picking these out, because remember we did that together because we love each other and we're a family and we're a community. Thank you for your help. And I was saying that I really liked how secure I felt in this. I did feel very secure in this middle strap. I will say that when your feet start to swell, because feet just swell in heels, it's not a natural position for your foot to be in, this felt kind of tight. Uncomfortably tight, yes. But I also had them on for hours. Like, we got to the wedding at 4. I was back in the hotel at like 2 in the morning. So it got very tight. But the rest of it, I loved. And for a wedding that was 99% outside, for these to be sat in, I think this held up so well, just being in grass and all of that kind of stuff. So glad I chose these, and I look forward to wearing these for more formal events. I have another wedding coming up in November, so might wear these again. And also we'll be doing another pack with me video. So yeah, these. I am so happy with the way that the Gilda and the Hervé Léger dress came together. I love that brides are doing this thing now where they provide flip-flops or ballet slippers, yada yada. I think it's really, really, really nice. But I've also been noticing people are bringing their own. I'm not trying to tell y'all what to do, but it's not the cutest look. I'm sorry. Like, unless you have a bag that can hold these things, like walking into someone's wedding with flip-flops or ballet slippers or flats or having them half hanging out your bag, it's just like not a good look. I hate it. So that's why it was so important to me to find a pair of shoes that I knew I'd feel comfortable wearing all night. Also, I know we're not talking about dressing for weddings specifically, we're talking more about what to pack, but please invest in an evening bag. It's another peeve of mine. I do not like seeing someone in a formal dress in a big old tote, unless you have to carry it for medical reasons, because I also know people who have to carry medical devices on them at all times. Invest in a good evening bag. The bag I wore was this one. So this is the Saint Laurent Uptown Envelope. It's funny because she's actually quite flat, but it expands. So of course I didn't overpack it, but because it's an envelope, you can kind of put more in it than you think. So this is what I wore, but I have a lot of great evening bags that are not this expensive. You can get them on Amazon, you can get them on Macy's. Little plug, I was the buyer for Macy's private brand handbags for 2 years, and evening bags was a huge part of our category. So there are some really, really, really great evening bags out there at Macy's. There might be one named after me. Yes, the Nicole, it exists. But yeah, there are lots of really great evening bags out there, and a great formal look has a formal shoe and a formal bag. That's what makes it look a formal look. So that was ready to go, packed. For the bridal shower, brides like themes, okay? Do the theme. I hate themes. I know there's some people who are my friends who are watching this who are like, don't do this, Nicole.
Don't say that.
I do not love a theme or a dress code, but when you're given one, especially by a bride, just do it. So for the bridal shower, the theme was garden couture with a nod to Africa specific. But Ashley Blaine is like, I just knew she was really gonna do it. So I too wanted to really do it. So the look that I decided to wear was this Kai Collective Gaia tube dress. I ordered this dress actually, I think when it dropped, because I was like, I know I'm gonna have somewhere to wear it to. I don't know where, but I know I'm gonna have somewhere to wear it to. And so I packed that with this little Zara heel. This is a leather sandal. I'm gonna do a video on how to shop Zara. I always give their leather a try because I think it's reasonably priced. And I think for a fast fashion shoe, you want it to be real leather, because if you really like it, the last thing you want is to scratch it or damage it and have to toss it. Leather can be repaired. So I did it with this little shoe. Also did it with this little Jacquemus bag. So it was like a really fun, colorful look. I love the little Jacquemus bags. They're so easy to pack. Now I have the bigger size, like the largest Chiquito size, and that is not an easy bag to pack. I took that to Jamaica like 2 years ago and distorted it in the bag. So that's a bag I will never pack. Ever, 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 ever. Another tip, when you're packing for a weekend, try to make sure your accessories can do double duty. So I never try to pack more than 3 pairs of shoes, because it's usually a carry-on. So where are all these shoes going? And it's just, it's too much work trying to make a pair of shoes go for every single look. So once I have packed the official things that I absolutely have to dress for, I try to make sure I can wear those accessories for different things. And that also goes with bags. Every look can't have its own shoe and bag. By the time you do that, you're checking bags. And the third official wedding thing was the pool party. So like I said, a lot of brides are putting more events in a wedding weekend. This one was actually hosted by a friend of the bride, one of our sorority sisters who lives in LA and has a gorgeous home in Sherman Oaks and a gorgeous pool. So she decided to host all of us who are coming out of town to just kind of catch up and get together on that Saturday at a pool party. Now, I have a lot of thoughts about what you should wear over a bikini. We could talk more about that in my Palm Springs video because I'm going to be wearing more swim and I was only packing one swim look for this. But this is the thing. Cover-ups are only for if you are at a resort. That's it. Do not wear a cover-up to somebody's house. Don't do that. Do not do that. And also, don't wear a look where you have to change into your swim. Because luckily, this woman, this gorgeous, hospitable woman, Kelly, was hosting us. But that don't mean we all have free range up in our house and be treating it like a pool club. So you want to wear something where you can wear your swim under your look, but it's also not distracting to the look. Whenever I'm wearing a halter swim bikini, I always wear a halter dress or halter top over it. Just in case I don't actually get into the swim, it's not a halter top hanging out of spaghetti straps. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't look crazy. So in this case, I wore this cute little leopard Monica Hansen bikini. I absolutely love this bikini. One of the reasons I do is because these triangles have a little bit of padding in them. I got small boobies, so we need all the help we can. And I got this from Revolve. I love this bikini. And so I wore it with this halter petal and pup dress. So once the dress was on top of the bikini, you couldn't really see it. You got a little glimpse of the bikini strings, but it wasn't distracting. The reason why I say that is because when it comes to pool parties, you never know what we're all about to be doing here. Is it an in the pool party or is it a by the pool party? So you don't want to come dressed in like a full mesh cover-up bikini and there's people's parents up in there, grandparents up in there, like you just really don't know. I think that's really comes down to every bridal event. You are a reflection of the bride to her family. So I always try to like wear something where I know I can gauge the situation, like how wet and wild is this really about to get. So I love this little petal and pup dress. I was influenced by Monroe Steele. I actually have it in two colors. So that's what I wore. And I wore my little strappy sandals from Zara, which I've had for so long. They have the tiniest little heel. So they're easy to walk in. Remember I said I only had max three pairs of shoes to pack? This was the third. Because the other two were higher heels, about 90 to 95 millimeters. I wanted this little kitten to be able to get through any day that I had. Tip when it comes to kittens, because remember I said in my last video, I believe kittens have a place. I love a kitten that laces up the leg. It just makes the shoe look sexier and higher than it actually is. So yeah, I wore those with the petal and pup dress and the bikini. So those are my three official wedding looks. I had three pairs of shoes, three bags. This was the third, another little Jacquemus. I just love these little bags. They pack so easily. They pack so easily. And it was perfect with that petal and pup look. So like I said, the accessories and the bags were for the official looks. So back to our checklist. We've packed our travel. We've packed our official wedding looks. We've packed our PJs. And we have three shoes, three bags. That's it. So what are we doing in the question mark time? This is actually my favorite thing to pack for. Like, this is the stuff that gets my like fashion packing brain going. You know what I mean? Because it's like, you already know what you're wearing for the official stuff. I know I'm wearing formal, I'm wearing black. I know I'm wearing garden African couture. I know I have a pool party, but these other times of day where it's like, what are we doing? Those are my favorite things to pack for. Because remember, this is where it gets strategic. You want to make your shoes and bags work for these looks, but you also don't know what you're doing. So these are the two types of looks I like to pack when I don't really know what I'm doing. Number one, a pair of jeans. Pack one good pair of jeans. A pair of jeans that if you wore them with sneakers because you were just literally running down the street to get a coffee between events, they work, or a pair of jeans for a night out. Again, you are a reflection of the bride to their friends and family and people who have traveled. So I feel like sometimes when there's like a free night, people are like, let's go to a bar, let's do this, let's meet in the hotel lobby, let's do this. If you don't know what the vibe is, having a pair of jeans and a cute little top are just, it's a perfect look. So with my pair of jeans, I packed two little tops. The first is this Zara halter. Love this. I've never gotten to wear this, and I was like, LA could be a fun place to wear it. And I knew I could either wear it with my little Zara lace-up sandals, or I could even make it a pop of color with the pink heels. So I knew one of those two could work, and I knew this little Jacquemus bag was gonna work with it. So that was a great little top to wear with a pair of jeans. And then I also packed this little Zara bralette that has lace-up strings across the body, because I knew, again, I could wear with that with the pink sandals as a pop of color, or I could wear it with the little Zara lace-up, which is actually how I did wear it. I wore it with the little Zara lace-ups and the little Balenciaga bag that I wore for travel. So a pair of jeans and one or two cute little tops, that is one thing I like to pack. The second kind of look I like to pack when I don't really know what we're doing is a slip dress. I love a slip dress. If you follow me on Instagram, you saw that I did a reel on slip dresses with sneakers. Can't just keep talking about it. We think too often about it. We can't just be cautious about it. I wanna get wild. Take me for a ride, boy. Show me you outside, boy. Know it's been a while, boy. I could do a video on that for you guys too. If you're interested, just put in the comments and I'll do it. But I like to pack a slip dress, because with this little slip dress in this champagne color, this is also from Zara, I know that I could wear it with the lace-up sandals and do either Jacquemus bag. I also know if we on some chill stuff, I could wear it with the Jordans and do the Balenciaga bag. That's why I love to pack a slip dress. It's easy to dress up or dress down. So between this slip dress, the jeans, the blazer, and the two tops, I kind of had a bunch of little mix and match kind of looks that I could do depending on the vibe. I want to always make sure that I'm dressed for whatever the vibe is. And the thing about dressing for whatever the vibe is, I think a lot of people think the best dressed people stand out in a good way. You want to stand out in a way that's like, she is the best dressed person in the room for what we're doing. Not, you wore a club dress and all of us are just going to the rooftop bar. Or you're in a body con and we all just decided to get coffee before we head to the ceremony. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you want to have little different looks for, like, don't know what we're about to do, but we're free to do it. So to recap, one, get organized. Make your list based on how you are spending your time. Two, plan your travel looks. Plan your travel looks, because you just never know what can happen when you're traveling. Three, make sure your accessories happen for the official wedding looks. And as far as official wedding looks, go with the theme, go with the vibe. Remember, you're a reflection of the bride or the groom. You don't want to be dressed too sexy, too crazy, overdressed, underdressed for whatever we're doing. So plan those looks the most meticulously. Those are the looks you really invest in packing for your accessories. Four, when you don't know what we're doing, make sure you have day and nights slated in your little organizational look where it could be whatever. And you want to make sure those looks work with all of the accessories and shoes you've already packed. Do not stress yourself out trying to find accessories and shoes for these looks when you don't even know what we're doing. And when you don't know what we're doing, my two go-to ideas are jeans and a cute top, because you can wear them with the outerwear that you brought, or you can wear it alone, or a slip dress, because you could do that for day with a pair of sneakers, or night with one of the pair of heels that you brought. So that is my methodology to packing for a weekend. I have a couple weekends coming up, y'all. I mentioned Palm Springs is coming up. That's a girls' trip. That's gonna be a really fun one to pack for. I'm a Howard alum and homecoming is coming up, and I hope it's not canceled. So that'll be a fun one to pack for. So there'll be more of these videos coming. And also there'll be links to every single thing that I packed in the description. So I hope that you enjoyed this video and I hope you found it informative. And if you want more practice with this, like I said, there's more videos coming, and I'll see you guys next time.